Hi everybody, today is a good day because I've just received from PCBWay this parcel. PCBWay is currently sponsoring this project, so I would like to thank them for this sponsorship. Inside the box, of course, there are PCBs. Here is one of them. The quality of the PCBs are absolutely beautiful. Silk screen is sharp and the black paint is shiny and very nice. This PCB is quite simple. It will be equipped with an ESP32 and connectors here to connect load cells. Here I can add a rotary encoder and here I can add an OLED display. This project aims at determining automatically the center of gravity of RC planes. So let's take one. Here is a small foamy plane. What we want to do is determine the position of the center of gravity, which is here under my finger, almost at 40 millimeters from the leading edge. To determine the center of gravity, we can use such a device. This. Measure the distance between the leading edge to this leg, have something which is absolutely perpendicular, and apply this kind of formula if we wait here and there. So we compute the moment from this point, which will be the measure of the weight here multiplied by the length here, and we can find the center of gravity with this formula. So the center of gravity is the moment divided by the total weight of the plane. So the total weight will be the addition of the weight on this scale and the weight on this one. So to have this system working, we can use a kitchen scale and measure manually the weight and then apply this formula. It works. But we can also use something which is a little more modern and smart. That is my PCB, which is already soldered. So here, the connection to the load cells, the ESP32, rotary encoder which will be used later, and the capability of having here an OLED display for displaying the information and the results. But what I've done is that I have coded an application in order not to use this and rather use my Android phone to have something more user-friendly. I have also designed these two scales. Each one is equipped with a load cell here, another one here. Under the box here inside is the HX711 amplifier, which is then outputting information and going into the board for computations. If we want to use this system, we have to put the plane holder on the scales. We have to measure precisely here the distance, which is 210 millimeters, and we have to put the plane above the holder, the stand. As we want to measure the center of gravity relative to the leading edge, we have this point of the wing to touch this leg. So now we can power the system. This will be done with a simple USB power bank. And the system will boot automatically and try to enter into communication with an Android application that I have written, which is here on my phone. So Center of Gravity Finder. If we open the system, we have something which is not normal, and it is normal that it is not. The tar of the system, as on any scale, hasn't yet been done. So we have to tar the load cells. See here? Now the front scale and the back scale see 0 gram on each of them. And we can, of course, put the plane again on the holder. And the application will give us automatically the center of gravity, which is 38.89 millimeter from the leading edge. So you can move the battery inside the plane to try to correct the center of gravity, but you can also enter into a second mode of operation where the application will tell you how much weight to add to the nose or to the tail, knowing that you want to get a target center of gravity of 38 millimeter, and you will put the lead at L1 distance from the leading edge, that is 150 millimeter. So now you have to add 3.3 grams into the nose. It means that the plane is tail heavy. If I push here on the nose, up, and now the plane is nose heavy, and you have to add weight to the tail or to the nose. So this system is very simple and allows to center almost any plane. Here we have used the system with a very small foamy plane. But if you go to the description of this video, you will find the links of this project showing how to build it from scratch, how to get the application to compile it, how to compile the firmware for the ESP32. Everything is open source, so you can do this system very simply. As you can see, the electronics is fairly simple. There is almost nothing. This is 3D printed. This can be either 3D printed or laser cut. I have chosen the solution of laser cutting the plane holder because it was faster than 3D printing. But if you prefer, you can do it in the both manner, 3D printing or laser cut. All the files are accessible on printable.com. And everything, as I said, is accessible on the Hackaday's project page, where all this is fully described. So I hope that this system is something that you will enjoy. It's very efficient, indeed. I haven't shown you that you have to calibrate the scale. So this is done here. You remove the holder, you put a calibrated weight, which is 500 grams here on the scale, and you make the calibration. Front scale is now seeing 500 grams. You do the same thing on the back scale calibration. Back scale is seeing 500 grams, and everything is now calibrated. You have to make the tar again, and here it is. So if you want to make it, don't hesitate. You can order the PCBs on PCBWay shared project page. It's very cheap, fast delivered. And thank you again PCBWay for sponsoring this project. Goodbye everybody.